If your lawn is green in the late summer, you're either irrigating or you have a lot of weeds like I do here in this patch. The brown spots, those are the areas with my actual grass, perennial rye and fescue, but the other little green patches are all weeds. So this spot right here, that is actually crabgrass. Your typical crabgrass grows wide and flat, and you can see there its leaves are much wider than the grass leaves. This one, of course, you know the pokey one, that's a thistle. You can pull those out, but you want to try to get all of that taproot if you can. This little guy, it looks like it's a regular blade of grass, but it's very strong and spiky. It's actually called nutgrass, and its stem is very strong and you almost woody-like. That's called nutgrass. And this one is flat, very common weed. It's called spurges, and it's easy to pluck out. You can see the weed, the root system on it is very shallow. It's almost a little bit milky. We also have another one that has a flower like this, and its leaves are wide and broad, usually in a cluster. Leaves kind of look like that, and it's called plantain, another common weed that we might find. And hey, don't forget our friend the dandelion. How do you get rid of them? Well, you just want to make sure that the turf itself is stronger and you have it well fertilized. Let it grow up over some of these weeds and it'll cover it up. And then you can just sit down anytime you want to and check out a few clover leaves. And that again fills in a lot of times as we get into the fall season. It has a white little flower on it like this that the bees really love. And also it's fun to sit here and look for a four-leaf clover. No, three. I guess I'll be looking for a while. Get out there and get growing.